How to use Slack on Mac. In this Slack tutorial on Macbook, I will show you how to install Slack, how to create a new workspace, and how to invite a person to it. Also, we will talk about how you can join a Slack workspace. In the last part of the video, I will show you how you can manage a workspace and how you can install an app on the Slack. Let's get started. How to install and create community on Slack for Mac. Slack is a new way to communicate with your team. It's faster, better organized, and more secure than email. Slack is a channel-based messaging platform. With Slack, people can work together more efficiently, connect all their software tools and services, and find the information they need to do their best work, all within a secure enterprise-grade environment. To install the Slack app on your MacBook, you will need to open the App Store. On the App Store, search Slack. Click on Get. Click on Install. You might need to put your fingerprint or password to allow the install, so complete this requirement. Click on Open. Click OK for Slack to access files. Also, click Allow for Slack to send you notification. Here, you will need to create a new account or sign in into your account. Let's click on Get Started, as I do not have an account on Slack. A browser window is open with two possibilities. You can try to create a new workspace for you and your team, or just sign in into Slack if your team already uses this software. For this demo, I will create a new Slack workspace. So click on this button. Write your email and click Confirm. Check your email for the 6-digit code and write it here. Write your name of the company or team name and click Next. Write a description for the team and click Next. Here, you can add teammates and get a link to get invites. For now, I will skip this step, but you can add whatever person you want to add to the team. Now click on See Your Channel in Slack. Click Open Slack. You have now installed Slack on your Mac. How to join community on Slack for Mac? For you to join a community, you need to be invited by somebody. You can be invited directly with a link, or simply the manager of the community can invite you. If you already received an invitation, just go into the email and click on the link. If not, you can click Get Started. If you wish to create a new community, click on Create a Slack Workspace. I already talked about this feature in a previous video, so you can check that. Click on Sign in to Slack. Write your email and click Confirm. Now check the email to see if you are already a member of the team. You see, I already have an email with the invitation from Slack. If you have not received that, you will receive when you do the previous action an email called Confirm Your Email Address on Slack. Click on that email. Click Confirm Email Address. Now you will see the workspaces you were invited to. If you wish to join the community, just click on Join. Write your full name and a unique password. This will create an account on Slack. Click Create Account. It can take a bit of time until the account is created. At least for me, it took around 1 minute. You are now in the Slack app from Google Chrome. To join the community and log in also to the app, click on the name of your profile from the top. You will get this menu. Click on Open the Slack app. Click Open Slack. You have now joined the community. In the community, you can send messages, files, send private messages, and even do calls. You have channels where you can talk about a specific topic. Slack is amazing, and you can try to use it to understand it how it works. But if you use an instant messaging app, you will not have any problems, as Slack is very intuitive. This is how you join community on Slack for Mac. How to manage community on Slack for Mac. In this tutorial, I will give basic information on how to invite user to a community, how to create a channel, and also we will visit the settings page. After you have created the community, the first page you have is the invite section. If you do not see this page, you can click on the link from the left section, invite people. Write the name of the person and the email. Click Invite to send an invite to the email. How you can see, a new person has appeared on the left part. Let me show you how to create a channel. Channels can be organized around anything, and the workspace can have as many as needed. There's no limit. They're available for all plans: Free, Standard, Plus, and Enterprise Grid. Click on the plus button near the channel. We can create private and public channels on Slack. What are public channels? They're open for all members to join, and anything posted is searchable by users. By default, all members of a workspace, but not guests, can create public channels. Workspace owners can change this permission and limit channel creation for certain roles. Private channels. Therefore, discussion that shouldn't be open to all members, so you must be invited to join one to view it in Slack. By default, all members of a workspace, including some guests, can create private channels. Workspace owners can change this permission and limit channel creation to certain roles. Write the name of the channel and description. Select if the channel should be private or public. I will do a private channel. Click Create. How you can see, when you create a private channel, you get the option to invite team members or guest users. You can do that by writing the email or the person's name. Let me skip this for now. How you can see, private channels have a lock on it. Those can be viewed by the person who has permission. Also, if you forgot to add somebody or you wish to add somebody to the channel, you can click on Add People. You get a notice that says anyone, if it is added to the channel, will be able to see the content of the channel, even the old messages, so you must be careful. Let's add the person as a test. write the email, select the person, and click Done. Now these two persons have a channel to talk. Let's also add a public channel. Click on the plus button near the channel. Write the name of the channel and description. Click Create. On the Invite section, leave selected Add All Members or Add Specific People. And also, you can leave selected Automatic Add Anyone Who Joins the Workspace. Click on Done. You now have a public channel with all your teammates. In the next part, we are going to talk about apps on Slack. What are apps? Apps are software that connect a tool or service, like Google Drive or Jira, to Slack. Apps can be built by Slack, third parties, or your own team. Add apps to Slack to centralize and streamline your work. With all of your tools in one place, you can easily share information by sending a relevant message in Slack to another service, or by creating tasks in your project management software directly from your workspace. Click on Apps button from the top. The Slack app directory is the place to go to browse third-party apps whenever you're looking for a specific tool or you want to see apps available for your line of work. Each app in your app directory is built to work with Slack. To use most Slack apps, you'll need an account with the service you'd like to use in Slack. App developers may choose to make all features of their Slack app available for free or require the paid account with their service. Workspace members can add apps by default, but Workspace owner can choose to restrict this permission. When you've found an app you'd like to use, click the Add to Slack button and follow the prompts. If you don't have permission to install apps, you may need to submit an app request instead. Let's see how this works. I will want to link Zoom with my current Slack workspace, so I can make meetings real fast. Click Add on the Zoom app. Here, you will need to click Add to Slack. You will have two possibilities, to install Zoom for all users or only for your account. Because I will use more Zoom, I will install it into my Slack account only. We are redirected to the Zoom page permission access. We need to allow this permission for Zoom to work. Click Allow. Zoom has been installed on your account. You can close this window if you like. How you can see on Slack, I have now an app zone. Once an app is installed and connected to Slack, you can start using it right away. Some Slack apps have bot users that can send direct messages to members and post messages in the channels. You may get a welcome message with tips for getting started and other messages to help get the most out of your app. Other apps have a home tab where you can view information, configure app settings, and more. Now let's talk a bit about the settings and permission we have on Slack. Click on the top zone where is your name. Here, you have lots of options for your settings. You can set up yourself to be online or offline, or lots of stuff for notification and others. You can check them out and see how you can set up it to be okay for you. On the settings and administration, we can set up lots of settings. Use this option to set up your account properly. We will talk in a future video about these options, as there are so many as it is hard to put it in one video. But please note, you can set up workspace settings, customize your workspace, manage members, and manage apps, so you have many things to do here. This is a short tutorial on how you can manage and set up your new team on Slack for Macbook. If this was useful, please like, share, and subscribe. You can also watch more videos from the right. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them in the comments area below.